The right hand side armrest just started to like go down and up all the time without the button pressed, which is right here. So what I did is I just popped the top off. You can see there's some clips here, four screws that you need to take out, 1, 2, 3, 4. The flat part is the front. This angled part is the back. So angled back, flat front. Okay, now that just, and inside here, well, there's a few things. First of all, my spring that's supposed to keep this under button down here working, and subsequently engaging this to click as it goes up and down and to stay still, which it's not doing. That spring is in here. It just fell in there because that's what it does. But anyway, something broke in here that caused that spring to come loose. And that thing that broke off is right here. You can't see it. It's really teeny. It's a little circle cylinder. It's about, there's a little circle on the piece of plastic. There, you can see it now. And this actually just sits on there like that. And then the spring sits over that like this. Okay, but the problem is when this spring is tensioned, it puts a lot of pressure on this little teeny tiny, you know, piece of plastic, and it just snaps off. And I scraped this until it's smooth. Okay, now I'm gonna drill straight down. I'm gonna make it a little bit bigger. This is a 9/64 inch, you know, diameter drill bit. It just so happens to fit the screw I'm putting in there pretty tightly, and it just so happens to be about the size of the original piece of plastic. So here I go. Screw that in there like that. Now what I have is a hole where that little nub used to be. Okay. Now I can put it all together. Put the screw in there like that. Put the, oops. I'm gonna put it in there so that it, this little end of the spring goes in that little slot there. And this is the part that will be tensioned later. And then I simply screw it in there. Okay, now it's a pretty nice tight fit. So now you can see it sticks out a little bit. I'm gonna put that a nut, and that will hold everything tightly together. Okay, so now that that's ready to go, the armrest needs to be fully inserted. If it's extended, then you won't be able to get it in there. So be sure to, you know, put the armrest all the way down. You'll see this at the top. Now, again, when this goes in there, you don't want it to be up. You want it to be down, okay? Because you don't want it to engage anything. It should slide right in, just like that. Now, it's not all the way down. That's because the armrest is fully extended or depressed. So I'm going to extend it, extend the armrest a little bit, and you can see this part just moved down. That's me extending it from underneath. Now, when I touch this, it'll just slide right in here. Should slide in here. In here. It actually hits that piece of plastic right there. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to clip that little piece of plastic off like this. I'm going to say goodbye, plastic. You can see I just broke that off of there. Just enough so that the head of the screw doesn't touch it. Now I'm going to slide this back in here. And as you can see, the screw head does not engage there, and it can move freely. Okay, Now I have the spring loaded because I pushed it down as I put this top back on here. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to put, you see these little screw holes, I'm going to put this, and again the arrows tell you what way it's supposed to go. This, you're a little bit at an angle. I'll screw these in like that. Squeeze it on there with my hands. Oh, there we go. Now it's all back together. Okay. And now what you can do is you can see that this is loaded again. You see that? See how the spring, the clip is loaded? Now I can extend it. I'm gonna push this and extend it. And let's listen for a clip. Whoops. Okay, here it goes. Oh, there it goes. It engaged. Let's try again. Oh, it engaged again. Okay, so now we're back in business. And that is how you fix your armrest for the Branch ergonomic chair.